In May this year, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, the Commander-in-Chief of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, made changes in the UPDF command in Karamoja sub-region, where he replaced Brigadier Joseph Balikudembe with Major General Don Nabasa as the UPDF 3rd Infantry Division commander based in Moroto, Karamoja, and other commanders were also changed. 3 months down the road, legislators from Karamoja say they have registered tremendous progress in restoration of peace in the area, which was torn apart by raids.
The situation is a bit improving security-wise compared to before, because I have been seeing most of the commanders, especially the branch commanders that have been deployed in different locations in Karamoja. They are very active on the ground.
Particular command has made the effort to these activities fertile. They have tried and they follow them to the dot and return the cows. So the condition is improving.
Legislators further say the security strategy of the new command in Karamoja of assimilating with local communities has yielded good intelligence information that has helped to tame the cattle rustlers commonly known as the Karachunas.
New command has steered the region. It's working well. I see very good working relationship with all the people, all the structures in Karamoja, and people are responding very positively. So many things happening in the shortest period possible. I think there was some gap, there was something lacking, especially on intelligence.
The command now has made conditions unbearable for some of them, and the only solution is to hand over. You know, if I told you, if there is no success in an activity, in the raiding, then there is no use of the gun. But if the success was there, they raid and they are not apprehended, they are not caught or attacked, they will think it is a normal procedure.
According to Hilary Lokwang, normalcy has returned in his constituency with more notorious Karachunas volunteering to return guns on their own without force. He believes this has been achieved through good working relations between top commanders of the disarmament operations and senior leaders across the sub-region.
There have been some of the notorious warriors who have been terrorizing people on the roads, robbing the border boys. I saw them coming out to apologize, and they were returning the guns. And coming out to apologize that they forgive us for what we have been doing. But I want to thank the president for giving the window to warriors, for giving them amnesty.
However, Karamoja MPs want government to fulfill its pledge to the reformed cattle raiders in order not to tempt them to slide back into raiding. In this, they want the project of distributing iron sheets to the reformed Karachunas.
The government promised them something. It's the government to deliver, because I have been seeing warriors being issued with the cards, those ones who have returned guns. They have issued them with the cards, meaning that those cards, when the government has to give them something, they should present the card.
The programs that failed, like the iron sheets which were stolen, the goats which were not given, are you saying that alone, until that is done, we have communicated to the community to be calm. Government is in charge.
Karamojong legislators also want the government to set aside some funds to compensate households that lost property and relatives at the height of insecurity which ravaged the area for close to a year.
We have already written all those, like people who have lost the cows in the hands of the army, those ones who have lost lives. Seldomly, the president is on strategy. As always, compensated some of them. But it is already a process which is on.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.